Thread milling has a lot of advantages over traditional tapping cycles, such as better thread tolerances, better tool life in harder materials, and a need for fewer tools to cut the same range of hole sizes. Users have been asking for more advanced control over the lead moves for thread mill, so starting in Mastercam 2025, it's received numerous updates. The entire thread milling toolpath has been gone through and organized to improve the workflow, along with adding some new features. Thread mills are versatile, in which the same tool can be used on both external threads, internal threads, and multiple diameter holes and body sizes. Thread mills come in a variety of different sizes and pitches, with a single or multiple thread profile. Let's create a thread mill operation on an ID feature. So let's go through and create a new thread milling operation. And we'll go down and select this ID hole here. And we'll click the green check. We'll choose tool 1 1/4 inch thread mill. And here on this page, we can see a new checkbox, the tool edge feed rate. So normally the feed rate would be output from the center of the tool. And you'd have to use a formula to calculate what the feed rate is where the contact point of the tool is to your geometry. Now, we added this checkbox to automatically do this for you. So when you output your code, your actual feed rate would be reflecting your contact point feed rate. So let's go to the cut parameters page. We'll make sure we're an ID thread and we'll machine bottom to top. And here we added, just for visibility, the spindle direction and cutting direction, so you can quickly confirm that you're going the right direction. And we can go down to tool axis control and make sure we're outputting on 5-axis. And let's just turn off graphical planes for visibility. And we'll go to the lead in and lead out page. This is where, you know, most of the changes are. So we can turn off start and end at center, and it unlocks a couple things. We have plunge after first move and retract after last move. Now, if you notice, the entry and exit are now separated, so you can have your separate controls for both of those conditions. And line length, between line length, we can add some distance here, so 0.1 for both. What this is doing is adding a linear move that allows us to turn on and off your cutter comp before your circular interpolation. So in certain cases in ID threads where you don't have that perpendicular entry or exit to turn that on and off, we now have this motion that will start and end outside of your actual hole. And we can actually click the apply button and we can turn plunge and retract after and before the last move. And we see that we have this linear move here outside of your hole. We also added spindle speed and feed rate overrides on your entry to allow users to really control their engagement into material, so the tool has a better chip load when it's ramping into material. So the biggest change here is your gradual lead in and lead out. With this turned on, the tool will start engaging at the percentage specified, and it will go to your full engagement within the first half pitch or 180 degrees. And then the same thing applies on the lead out. It'll disengage over that half pitch. So this gradual engagement prevents that sharp engagement that can lead to more tool wear on your harder materials. So these new controls for Mastercam's thread milling toolpath are a great improvement for toolpath efficiency. Tool wear will be reduced and cutting conditions will more closely match the parameters specified by the tool manufacturer.